Hello everyone, I'll be bringing you another commentary today between LaG and LR. So this was on Uncharted Isle, let's go into it. So again, LR is basically the Finnish team, Finnish it is. Playing in either a Smurf guild or the new guild, I'm not sure. Alright, LaG is running AP spike with 3 Ellies, Mesmer, and LR is running double Mes for 2 frontline and probably Lightning Surge Ellie, not sure. Might have Spirit Bond. He's gonna be pretty happy if he has Spirit Bond against this. It would be actually a little bit difficult to collapse and kill him like you usually want to do with AP Spike. So we do actually see no snare on the Muck Flagger as well for LaG. Usually LaG, I think that they like to run Rip Flagger, and with AP Spike it's really nice to have a snare on your flaggers that you can deal with solo splits, especially in maps like this where you can collapse through the middle. But not running a snare today, so it will actually open up a split for LR if they do decide to do that. Make it quite difficult for LaG to deal with that. Because if LR just split and run flag in, then it means that LaG will have a very hard time dealing with that because they have to run flag and defend the split. And so they can use one monk flagger to do one of those things, but then they need to use their damage characters to do the other, which is really not what you don't want to be splitting away damage characters with this AP spike. One thing to notice about this kind of AP spike, I haven't really seen this sort of AP much before, but they do run Glyph of Sacrifice on I think 2 Ellies, yeah. They use like Lightning Hammer and Lightning Orb, so there's Lightning Hammer right there. Not able to score that kill, but so yeah, I haven't really seen that much before. I've seen it in the last like week or two a lot from LaG and Troll Wars, but it's very interesting. It makes it very hard to shut down the spike, and the spike can be very clean and a lot of damage coming in very quickly. I think that they were also running Conjure the other day, I'm not sure if they have this time, but yeah, okay, there's Conjure. So the spears will do a bit of damage as well, probably spec into Spear Mastery. So it's quite a deadly spike, but one thing that I think probably does get punished quite a bit, see the air tune get erupted right there on Vesto. The Vesto is not running Glyph Sacrifice, it's running Glyph Ellie Power, so that erupt on his air attunement could hurt him quite a lot because I think they're relying on him for defense and for some room as well. So he needs his energy, especially with Mindshock, you need to have a lot of energy. Holding flag on the Mindshock is actually kind of interesting. It can make it hard to hit Mindshock sometimes because you can't go into your higher energy set, so that's a little bit interesting. Because LR is not splitting, it would actually allow LaG to hold on the flag if they really wanted to. Especially because if LR decided to push up and try and kill the flagger, it would really open them up to their spikes. Well, possibly anyway, it would make it a little bit obvious because LR does a pretty good monk, so it would probably be pretty obvious if this assassin started pulling back to try and spike out frontline, so maybe that's why. They don't really see that as not a thing to do. So LR is pushing to the frontline right now. I think they did take one of them down. Nice save on Godly over here. Yeah, so it looks like one of the footmen is dead. Vesto is running the flag in, so actually while Vesto runs the flag in, it means that LR can probably run all over them, because LaG really have, I think, no kill power right now while they're running flag in LA. So it's actually a little bit risky, because it lets, you can see how aggressive LR is playing, they're just going in the backline right now, which is, you know, as AP spike, I think that you want to force the other team to sit on your midline. Because if they don't do it, you can kill them pretty easily sometimes. It looks like Vesto's actually caught out a little bit here. He uses the blind a little bit too early, gets taken off by the Harrier's Grasp, and he's going to be in some trouble right now. Sync was slowing down the monk there, and Vesto does go down. So that's the Mind Shock. He's going to have a little bit less energy because of the DP and less health now. And yeah. It looks like they're bringing out flag on the monk flag right now, so this will probably be, I'm guessing this will be a lot more beneficial for them, especially if they can score a kill right now. They don't need to run out just yet though, and they're actually running Dark Escape on the monk flag, which is interesting. It means that they probably anticipated having to run a monk flag, or hold a monk flag at least, because it means that he's a lot less mobile, there'll be a lot less responding to splits and stuff. Another part of that is probably that they're running incoming and fallback on the Assassin Paragon, I'm guessing, so might not need the speed boost on Flagger as much. So do see a kill right there on Jafai. He was pretty far pushed up in the range of every teammate of LaG. probably don't want to push that far up until you have some flag advantage, so it forces LaG to push out and run flag, which means that they can't spike as easily. So LaG is holding this flag to the last second, it looks like he's trying to score another kill before they start running. Which makes a lot of sense. There's Lightning Surge on Blood Red coming out. So LaG is holding this flag quite a lot. Nearly score a kill there on Blood Red. Spike comes out in LR, but it's saved again. Oh, sorry, they run the flag through, I didn't see that. So running flag through on the monk like this, LR could take advantage of this if they followed it with two damage characters. Like they could follow it with Dervish and Ellie, or you know, Warrior and Ellie, or just basically any two damage characters. And it would put LaG in a pretty difficult situation, because if they wanted to follow that, they would have to follow it with either one monk or their whole team. And if they follow with one monk, they'd leave them with one monk main team against three damage. If they follow with their whole team, it leaves their front door open to being pushed. So being pushed up this far in this position for LR, it would really allow them to take advantage of when LaG tries to run the flag, because it puts LaG in a really risky situation. And I think the longer that they don't take advantage of those flag pushes, the more risky it becomes for LR. You see that they have absolutely no pressure right now. And against AP spike, if you have absolutely no pressure, that just means you're waiting to die. So Jafar is standing behind the obstacles, so this is a nice move. Anticipate a spike coming on Jafar there by Ellie. Godly is actually quite far pushed up right now. In range of pretty much everyone. Looks like he was trying to hit someone back there. Looks like he's getting spiked, but looks like that spike was caught by something, probably by Ruffs, I would guess, considering not much damage came out. You see another flag coming in right now. Hello, not really opting to take advantage of this at all. Just gonna run another flag. So LR really are not in a situation where they can win this game. They're basically just waiting to die, it seems like right now. There we go, this is the first new death. There'll be DP on Jafai and on Kasparov. So I think that LR really have to change things up right now, just because having no pressure and just waiting to take more deaths, and the more DP you get in its AP spike, the more it snowballs against you. Running in another flag right now on Butters. They really need to make something happen soon, because if they take another death and get 30 DP on the Heal Monk or the Mesmer, it'd be very difficult for them to come back from it. Nice dark escape save. Very nice dark escape save, considering how low we got there. Oh, Ali's actually running Life Sheath, I didn't notice that, so that is quite interesting. I think that will actually help him quite a bit, to be honest. This got a kill there, so that's nice. Just as Butters came to main team, didn't think he got any skills off on that, so that was with 4 damage they scored a kill, so that's great news for LA that they can score a kill with 4 damage, but actually that might have been while the flagger of LaG was grabbing the flag, so that might explain why they got a kill with 4 damage. Pushing this flag a little bit with Sync, we'll see how LaG responds to this, it'll be quite interesting. So they're responding to it by pushing up their pro mark, which leave the solo monk at main team, which they're pushing on right now. But nobody else is pushing the flag with Sync. It would have been very nice if they kept pushing this with another player, because it would really pull that monk out further, which would leave the solo monk at main team more. So LR once again just seems to be waiting to take more deaths. Quite a risky spot to be in against AP spike. Another spike coming out. Good dark escape. We did see actually a 0 damage from E-Surge right there, so that means that he's got no energy on shield set. Nope, it just cast Guardian on shield set actually, so I don't know what that was. Might be mistaken. Dervish solo pushing Flagger. We really need another damage character up here to take advantage of this. They really shouldn't be able to run flag like this on a monk without any other teammates. Butters was coming in, but came in just a little bit late. If he had been here just 20 seconds earlier, it would have been a very risky position for LaG to be in. So LaG going back from the number 8 to grab another flag. So Darkscape popped again on the hill, Monkevella. And Butters, no, who's running a flag? Nobody running a flag yet, looks like, okay. LR is playing all out aggressive right now. And if LaG get the flag here, LR is gonna have to survive a long time without any pressure. Okay, and LR take a death. So this is very bad for LR. So, but that is actually only 15 DP on Godly though. If they took another 15 DP on Jafar, then it would have been really bad. But spreading up DP isn't as bad as if you get a lot of DP in one character, I think. Or two characters. That's by coming on Jafar this time. Oh, goes down, okay. That was a... Infuse nearly got off. So that was really close to being a save, but that'll be huge now that Jafar is 30 DP or 26 DP or something. So running flag on the dervish now, the LR is. They're not going to have any kill pressure again. Oh, was that just a... I think that was just a pit leak on the infuse. A very nice pit leak by Sense there. Okay, LR is double running, letting Jalaz LaG to push up quite a bit. Or at least it looks like they want to double run, thinking about it. This is gonna allow LR to possibly take control of the flag stand, and but they're not gonna do it. It looks like they're just going back for another flag. Yeah, it's interesting to see that LR is not willing to really fight over the bridge area. You know, fighting over the bridge and flag stand would really split up LaG and make it really difficult for them, especially with having no snares on their team. It looks like the only snares that they have are the knockdowns of the Ellie. So LR could probably play much more aggressively, splitting up, you know, just through the front door and the back door, if not, sorry, the front door and the flag stand, if not the back door. So LaG is just full running on the flagger now, not worried about taking deaths at all, pushing into the footman even. But this is actually going to be quite risky to push into the footman now that LR is running on the flagger, and Butters is the main team. So this is 5 damage. The main team for LR against just 2 monks of LaG. They're gonna get quite a risky position here. But not gonna take any deaths. Oh, actually nice PI on the Word of Healing. That didn't get to shatter this Ellie. Monk running flag through again for LaG. Oh, actually, 2 deaths there, 1 on Jafar, so that'll be either 30 or 45 DP on him, and a death on Blood Red as well, which just get packed in. Okay, that was a base res on Jafar. So if he has 45 DP, he either has 30 or 45. If he has 45, that's really bad news for LR. I mean, I think that they really have to switch things up, because checking a couple of deaths on LaG, it's not a huge deal. Taking a couple of deaths on LR is a massive, massive deal. Another spike coming in, Kasparov this time. Oh, it does go down. Pops Darkscape last second just for the shadow. And not able to be saved by the monks. Looks like Charmeli wasn't in position because he was running flag and not saved, not caught by Ali in time. But LR have done quite a good job actually. The monks have done quite a good job, I think, to stay alive for this long. Nearly taking a death there. It's like there was a diversion or shame or something on Kasparov. But yeah, usually we don't see teams survive against this kind of AP spike for this long without wiping the AP spike. You know, usually it's either kill or be killed, I think. So, okay. Split stun to come out from LR, which is very good, keeping this Mesmer away from main team so he can't get more DP. And he can actually do something on split side. So this two-man split is going to be really, really strong. Because LaG is probably not going to be able to just defend it with the flag out, so they're going to have to either collapse on it, or send back Prot Monk, or send back a damage character. All of those things are really not very optimal, collapse is the most optimal, but it might be quite difficult, I think. Especially because LR is, you know, quite an experienced team, they're going to see the cops coming a mile away. Oh, Neon's going kill down Kasparov. So they do get the back footman and back archer down. Probably need the bodyguard up this as well. Wesh just takes out the bodyguard quite quickly. They might actually... They could actually opt... Ooh, there was a heal burst on the guild lord rather than the bodyguard. That was almost a bit of a mistake. Godly going down though again, so that'll be either 30 or 45 on Godly, I can't remember quite, but... Ooh, was that a Aether Feast? Yeah, okay, Aether Feast, so this is actually quite good. It's gonna be quite self-sufficient on Split Side with the Wastrels. Yeah, I didn't realize he had Aether Feast. Usually he'll have Drain Enchantment on that slot, so it actually means that he's a lot less energy management and main team, but a lot better ability to split himself with that self-heal. So this split will go quite well for LR if they can do it again. I did see LaG just pull back the whole team right there. Looks like they're going to try and defend it with just the number 8. And when they get under a bit too much stress in the base, just collapse the whole team through front door, but that is going to put their NPCs in some risk. They're sending back a prop monk right now, so this is just leaving one monk in main team. Well, they're pushing in the front door, so this is going to actually be a very, very risky position for LaG to be in, I think. Especially if they pass this flag up right now, which they could easily do because they're ahead on flag. They're still holding the flag for LaG. Yeah, so we see two monks defending right now, so a lot of pressure going to be put on the solo monk and main team. He's getting trained out. Two frontline and a mesmer is going to be very good at training this guy out. Diversion on the iron palm right there. And yep, solo monk goes down. So the split proven very effective at pulling back the two monks. Yeah, so LaG is going to have to rethink how they defend this. Taking a lot of deaths here. I think that was just 15 DP on the heal monk of LaG there, so not too bad. Could have been worse. Shafai getting quite low, but Spiritbomb from Butters and Windborn is going to be fine. So Butters does have Spiritbomb, which is quite important to note, because that means that enemy collapse. As long as Butters plays it right, it's going to be actually not that easy to collapse. Desto actually out of position here a little bit. Need a collapse on by Sync, but Chrome Monk of LaG is going to follow quite closely. Well, not that closely, but closely enough to survive. And the two damage characters, Butters could now run back in. Butters actually opted to go to 19, that's actually quite interesting. If he was to go back on Split Side, they could get some NPCs down. Not sure what the thought process is behind going to main team here. Will allow LaG to have their two monks in main team, which makes him pretty much unkillable here now with the DP of LR. Okay, Butter's going back to Split Side. Yeah, so we'll see how LaG decides to defend at this time. They're probably not going to send back their prompt monk again because of how disastrously that turned out last time, almost in a full wipe. There, it looks like they might be positioning themselves to run through the middle. They're pushed up quite a bit. No, maybe through the front door. They need to deal with it somehow though, they need to make a decision. And this is actually really unfortunate for them, this the timing for LaG, because they have to run the flag in and they have to defend the split now at the same time, so they're probably going to lose a number of NPCs here. The promoc is going back, but this is going to make it... This is the worst position to be in almost while you're trying to get a flag in with one monk against 3 damage, but LR do not follow them and do push the front door instead. No NPCs down just yet, so actually probably quite a good job by this flagger monk to give up the NPCs, but the bodyguard surely... Okay, it doesn't go down, so great job by the flagger monk there. I don't know how to say your name, sorry. LR choosing not to push. Okay, LaG is going to collapse to the middle, so this could be... But they're actually not collapsing with all the damage, so this is actually going to allow LR to sit right on top of them because LaG isn't sending all the damage. Looks like they sent 2 damage through their base, through their own base. So this is going to mean that LR can just run right on top of them without any pressure. And this monk does get crippled by the Harry's Grasp and knocked down by the Iron Palm, and he's definitely going down here. So quite a risky collapse move pulled right there. Not keeping all the damage together, which allowed LR to play way more aggressively. than they would have been able to otherwise. So, LaG in quite a difficult position now. It doesn't look like they have really any way to deal with the split now that that collapse failed. I mean, unless they want to try collapsing again, but they would need to... I mean, that probably took away a lot of their confidence in collapsing. But without collapsing, there's really no way that they can deal with the split and have a strong main team. So LR is pulling ahead quite a bit here. LaG might try and go out and get this flag in to stop LR from boosting, but it would be quite difficult with a monk down. And LR are going to play it quite safe and just run back off the split side. This is an interesting timing though, because this monk is gonna res back at the base, and it's really the fact that he's dead is not really gonna give any advantage to LR, I think, unless they can score a kill in these couple of seconds before the base res. They're not taking advantage of the dead player by keeping the damage main team, but they are just gonna play it safe, which you have to respect. Oh, nice, great infuse by Castro over there. So the split is now in full effect again. Really having no snare on their flagger is hurting them so much. Like, if they had a snare on their flagger, then they could actually maybe get some collapses off through their own base, but... Okay, they're going to defend with the Mesmer now, which is going to slow down a lot of their damage on main team. It's going to make it a lot harder to score kills, and it's actually... Because his only damage is going to be E-Surge and Shatter. It's actually going to be quite hard for them to still defend this, even with the Mesmer and a Monk. Possibly. Should be able to get the bodyguard down maybe if they decide to, but... Might just be playing it safe. So yeah, this is... LaG is basically, I think, stalling to 28 with this split defense. They want to try and keep their NPCs up, and they pretty much realize that as long as they have to defend the split, it's going to be impossible for them to kill main team. So we'll see how LR play now that LaG is playing this much more defensive style. LR might just go balls to the wall, play full out aggressive, not even care about slowing down damage. Now that there's only 4 damage characters for LaG here. 3 damage characters now that Vesto is running. Chumley running flag, so they don't even care to play defensive at all still. Not worried about dying. Yeah, that actually would have been quite close if there was a deep wound on it, but no deep wound and more saved by the infuse. So that shows that they can actually still get quite low. LR can get quite low, even though there's only 4 damage characters from LaG. 3 Ellies do quite a lot of damage. Jumley gets the flag in. But yeah, I got to think that they're gonna lose this bodyguard eventually. I mean, the Wastrel is doing full damage against it since the bodyguard won't cast anything, since the Goldblood isn't under attack. It's actually really impressive that the Monk has been able to keep this all up for so long. But yeah, LR is just pushing it really deep now, just playing on the Monks only. As I said before, they just don't have to play defensive at all, since LaG is playing more defensively and really don't have much kill threat at all main team. So the Mesmer does now come to main team. LaG is going to try for sort of an all-in push right now, maybe lose a couple of NPCs. Nope, and send the Mesmer back. And send the Ellie back as well. One of them will be running flag there. Yeah, Ellie will be running flag probably, and Mesmer defending, I guess. Unless, okay, LaG is actually going all-in. So they're going to let some NPCs die here, maybe. Oh, nope, they're sending actually their kill monk back, so leaving a prompt monk at main team. This is very, very interesting. So this is extremely, extremely risky. The prompt monk is really not very self-sufficient, and Sync and Hemo are really diving this. Yeah, if anything, the most self-sufficient monk is the flagger, so... If you're going to defend with 2 monks, it's probably might be best to defend with the prod and the heal. Keep the flag in main team. So the balance stance gets taken up right away, and this is almost definitely a dead monk. Yeah. There's a blackout. Ooh, nice meteor though. Probably not going to be enough to save him if the Harry's Grasp comes in. Nope, it will be enough to save him. So great meteor there by whichever Ellie has meteor, I didn't see. And Lag actually will get out of this. Okay, well they will take a death. I was going to say get out of this without taking a death, but they'll take a death right there. And morale boost for LR and getting towards 28. It really seems almost unwinnable for Lag at this point. I think that was P-Block. Yeah, P-Block on the Spirit Bond. So Vesto up here with Chamelee. This is... yeah. Vesta come back to main team, just cap the flag and then capped over. But now that Lag have a dead Ellie, LR again don't need to play defensive at all. And with the morale boost as well, they'll have a lot of their health back, so... this is really... the next minute is all LR. Okay, the Ellie does get a res actually. I think that was a res Sig, I think, but I could be mistaken. That was from Vesto, who slashed Ritz, so it could have been a pack, but... either way, it might actually be the saving grace for Lag right here. As they're able to push out LR. But no, Vesta goes down, and unless they have a pact here on Saints, he's going to be down for a minute. Looks like Godly is watching for the pact, he's staying in range of Saints. He's pushing up just to be in range of him, but Saints knows it. You might see an Aegis, no. Promox not in range to Aegis. Alright, Flag and Monk is almost gone down, but he gets saved last second. There comes the Pact. It was a great job by him, by Saints, waiting till he saw the Godly wasn't watching him. And it's quite close to the base res timer, but he noticed that his Monks are in a lot of stress right now, and they need all the help that they can get. There's a split coming out from Lag right now, with Ellie, two Ellies, Assassin and Teal Monk, but looks like they'll probably get lorded right here. These Monks are likely dead after time. This is a very high stress situation for them to be in against three damage characters with almost no defense. See the blackout goes up again there. There goes one monk. We'll see the pact come out soon. Here it comes. A little disrupted. There it goes. Complicate from Godly. And this will probably be game. Yep, and we're probably going to see it with another pact and pact erupt soon. See if he can cancel out the complicate. Nope, gets complicated. And that is it, looks like. Vesto's given up. And yep, looks like the split had actually died. Sorry, I didn't catch that. Yeah, congratulations to LR for beating Lag. I think there must be 1 to 20 now. Anyway, good job to LR and good luck next time to Lag. Thanks for watching.